in the kick. Your butt in the shape.
What's up, my powerful peeps? It's Jameson, like the whiskey, and I'm feeling frisky. Let's get this mother effing party started. Today we're gonna work some back, back width with some pull downs and stuff, and we're gonna hit just a little bit of some shoulders and some biceps, guys. Let's get to it with a little one arm pull down here. So I really like the one arm variations of a lot of stuff lately. I've been doing like just a lot of single arm like pull downs and cable lateral flies for the shoulders, you know, single arm like freaking preacher curls. You can get a lot more just like isolation out of it. You can really focus on like the stretch, like look at how much more extension I can get out of that one arm, really reaching for it at the top. So that's my whole thing. I'm all about increasing that mobility at the same time as you're working on your strength training, right? Gotta keep these bodies agile, mobile. Okay, so we're just gonna do another little warm-up set here before we get to the hard working set. Switch it up. So I took yesterday off. That's another big thing that I'm big on. Everybody's, all these coaches nowadays have like their thing, right? Like if you watch like Greg Doucette, he's like, just go harder than last time, right? Go harder than last time type thing. Train harder than last time, however he says it. You know, you watch someone like Sam Sulik and he's like, just freaking crush it as hard as you can, like every set, like go till failure and then hit some partials, some long length partials and like, whatever you could do just to annihilate it, right? That's kind of their mentality, okay? Now that I'm over 40, feeling sporty, actually I'm over 50, I'll be 52 this year. I'm all about getting jacked, but without getting jacked up. So increasing that mobility and training smart. So like I said, I took yesterday off because I got this handy dandy little Aura ring here. It tracks my sleep and my, gives me a readiness score every day based on like your resting heart rate and your body temperature and like how much sleep you got the night before, deep sleep, REM sleep, like all these metrics. And my sleep was like, I got like 4.5 hours sleep. Sometimes I wake up and my mind's just going and I like can't wait to get into the gym or get to work. So I couldn't go back to sleep. So my sleep was shit. And that dropped my overall readiness score to like, I was in like the 60s or 70s, which is not ideal. So my body was just a little wiped out. I was feeling tired. So I'm like, I'm gonna skip the gym today. I had high aspirations of doing a video like this pretty much every day, but you know, I thought, you know, just to be on the safe side, I'm gonna take a little therapeutic recovery day. And it was really good for the body. I took a little siesta midday. So if you're getting up there in age a little bit and you still wanna get jacked without getting jacked up, you gotta listen to that body even more than you did when you were a young buck. Okay, so that was some one-arm pull-downs. Let's get to some side lateral raises, one arm again for a little warm-up set. Here's a little hustler's hack to get you jacked. Here, right here. Keep track of your weights and stuff so you can kind of know where you're at with your strength training. What are the best ways to avoid plateaus and to assess whether you're overtraining or not is to like, know where you're at with your overall load and your weights that you're using and how many repetitions you're able to get out of that, how many sets. Like the more you can keep track and be like a scientist with like what's working, what's not working, and you can really see like, you know, basically when you hit like a couple workouts in a row, when you're stagnated and you like can't beat your next, you know, personal record, your next PR, and you just stop progressing, you're like, maybe it's time to like switch things up a little bit, you know? So track if you want to get jacked. Okay, let's go to the one arm cable fly right here. Bam, hitting that middle deltoid. So I got just a light to moderate weight on here. I'm gonna do some higher reps on this set, just focusing on the slow negative on the eccentric. Little momentary, just a split second squeeze at the top, just like you're flexing that shoulder. Good full range of motion at the bottom, getting to that somewhat stretched position down here. So I'm gonna superset the back width exercises today with some delts, and then I'll probably just finish off with maybe a couple sets of some biceps. Biceps have always just kind of been my not lacking body part. You know, they've got a decent kind of genetics to them already, so, as opposed to my triceps, which I have to really try to work on. So I'm just gonna do a little maintenance on the biceps today. But I'm gonna push the back and the shoulders pretty hard here, because they're the ones that really help with your aesthetics as well too, right? If you have some like wide shoulders, a big thick like V-taper back, really gives you a little bit more of that Superman-ish look, right? So I really like to emphasize those chest, shoulders, back. Bam. Again, just a little warm-up set here, so I'm not even really pushing it that far. I'm probably taking it like 3 reps in reserve. Wow. Good. Okay, I'll rest a minute or two there, probably a couple minutes, and then I'll go back to the back. A little back and forth superset. Let's get it done. So there's a couple different tricks you can use to kind of like assess your overall systemic fatigue and where you're at and decide whether you want to take a day off or take a light day or something like that. So you can even just like ascribe yourself a certain numerical, you know, from 1 to 10 or something like that. Like, what's my fatigue today overall? You know, maybe if you're like a 7, 8, 9, you're probably like, oh, maybe I'm just going to scrap today and take it completely off. Or maybe if you're like a 5 or a 6, like light to moderate fatigue, you're just kind of like, ah, I could probably go to the gym, but maybe I just won't push it till failure today, you know? So get to know that body a little bit, even put it on your tracker. I have this thing called a Titan tracker that I use in my coaching program, where we assign like a numerical value and a grade to certain metrics and parameters that we want to track on a regular basis, so we can kind of guide our training from that. So I'm like 5 weeks into my summer shred program right now. And so I'm starting to see some changes, I think. I was looking at my before after pictures the other day, and maybe I'll pull them up on the screen here, and you can kind of see where I started and where I'm at now just after like the first month. It's noticeable, definitely. Pretty noticeable for a month, I think. Body fat's come down a little bit. My weight's been dropping. I'm hanging right around like 203 right now for the last several days, so I've been kind of staying there around that low 200s for a little bit. So I might, I don't even really care if I lose any more weight, but I just want to lose the body fat, and sometimes a little bit of weight has to come with that. So if I get down to, you know, 190 or something like that again, all good with me if I'm looking ripped and ready for summer. Okay, let's push it a little bit here towards the end. Wow. Oosh. Ish. Oh, yeah, baby. Okay, so, yeah, where was I? 5 weeks into the summer shred, and I think I'm pretty much on point. I'm maintaining my strength and my size for the most part. Decreasing the body fat, overall performance feels good. I feel better because like I'm just a little bit lighter and like not quite as like bulky and stuff as I was before. I was getting a little bit on the chubby side there, I felt like. So I just feel like a little more mobile, a little more agile, and I'm just a little leaner and meaner. So that feels good. I'm looking forward to seeing what the overall transformation is going to look like here in another couple months, because we're doing a full 12-week transformation, 3 months coming up here. And I'll finish right around my birthday in May. My birthday is on May 23rd. Oh, okay, focus, AJ, focus. Wow. Good stretch at the top. Wow. Good squeeze at the bottom. Wow. Slow, controlled negative. See how much more extension and reach I can get out of this by doing the one arm. I can really like get my body into it and lean into it a little bit. Get a phenomenal stretch in those wings. Wow. back's really important too. You gotta feel it working. Like if you're not feeling your actual wings and your lats working, you probably got way too much bicep engagement. A couple more. Oh yeah. So one of the big things that helps with the back is this mind-muscle connection of thinking about, instead of pulling with your arms, visually thinking about pushing with your elbows. So push your elbows down, and rather instead of pulling with your arms, just pretend like your hands are like extensions of your elbows here, and you're driving the elbows down like the resistance is underneath you. Lights are dimming out here because I've been inactive. Come on, lights, jump on. So think about that when you're doing your back exercises. Don't just pull with the arms because you're gonna get more biceps out of it. Push with the elbows, guys. Okay, let's call that our first working set of the one arm lat push downs, and then we'll make this the first working set of the lateral raises, because the other one was still kind of easy peasy warm up set stuff. And I'll probably do just two, you know, working sets a piece for the pull downs and the lateral raises here. So I'm bumping up the weight a little bit because that last weight was a little bit too easy for these guys. So this might be, we'll see how many reps I get out of this. Good. That was a good 12 with probably like one or two in reserve, something like that. Perfecto. Yeah, and then that last set, depending on how I'm feeling, I might crush it with some partials or some drop sets or something, a little more advanced training methodology to really push it to the next level. Bah. Good, even those babies out. So yeah, you gotta kind of like, you know where you're sitting for the day on your overall readiness and ability to crush it. Whether you have one of the fancy little Aura rings that tracks your actual metrics on your readiness score, or you just take a, you know, kind of a subjective assessment, give yourself a grade for the day, how much energy, how much oomph you got, and then you can decide whether that's gonna be a really hard day where you can push it and do some like drop sets or rest pauses or some crazy stuff to really go past that failure point, or whether you're just like, nah, I'm just gonna stay a couple reps on reserve, just kind of pace myself today, right? If you want to win the race, you got to set your own pace. Okay, back to the one arm pull downs, final working set. Okay, giddy up, buttercup. We're gonna do a little drop set on this one, I think, because I'm feeling pretty strong. A day of recovery did me good. Burn, baby, burn. Ah. goes. Oh yeah. So if I was writing my logging book here, I would just write one arm lat push down, right side, 12 plus 6, because it was a drop set. So I did like 12 reps on the first set, hit pretty close to failure, dropped it down a plate, and then did another 6 more. So 12 plus 6 if you're writing that shit down. Okay, pound those liquids and get that hydration in there, gentlemen. We did a podcast episode on hydration the other day, and our Ultimate Man podcast. Check it out on either YouTube or Spotify. Just go to The Ultimate Man Podcast. And we did a really good podcast on the hydration, how much to get it in. Drink some water in between workouts, if you know, especially if your workouts are lasting 45 minutes to an hour plus or something. You know, for instance, for myself, I want to drink, as per the scientific recommendations, it's like 6.6 ounces every 15 to 20 minutes just to stay hydrated throughout the workout. So I'm not that specific with mine. I don't drink that many ounces. I just have some water every 15 or 20 minutes in between some of the harder sets to recover and make it easy peasy to implement. Got some branched chain amino acids in there, just kind of flavored up, give me some more aminos. And that's that. Stay hydrated. Okay, let's go. Second working set of the one arm pull downs. Doing a little drop set here again. We got 12 and 6 on the right arm. Let's see if we can match it. Oosh. Good set right there. Good. As you notice, I turned one way, facing one way when I did one arm, then I faced the other way when I did the other arm. Depending on the machine, it doesn't always matter that much. You know, just like I said, sometimes you just need to like position your own body to get that proper angle to feel. You just, as long as you can really feel it, working those lats when you're pulling down. So that was my last hard set. So I'm just gonna do a little flex here. Kind of like, I'm a big proponent of like doing a little isometric flex when you finish some of those harder working sets. So just get in like a bodybuilding position, you know, like how they do on stage here. Not that I'm a bodybuilder, I'm like a recreational bodybuilder. I don't even have aspirations of competing or anymore. I just like to do it for fun because I've always been into the lifting and stuff, but just isometrically flex those wings until you can really feel them really contract and engage. Almost to the point where like you're flexing so hard that they're gonna cramp. And then that's just gonna really develop that mind-muscle connection so you can learn to squeeze them even that much better. Whether you're in the middle of a working set or you're freaking pulling that weed eater cord or whatever the hell you're doing, right? It just becomes you a lot easier to like stimulate that contraction. And it's been proven that the people that can actually get that mind-muscle connection and flex their muscles consciously, even without a resistance, those people are stronger because they have that neurological response. So work on flexing those muscles after those hard working sets. Get that mind-muscle connection, and it's gonna make you even that much more of a beast Okay, second set, last set of the laterals. Here we go, yo. Okay, last set of the lateral raises. I'm gonna do a little drop set on this one too. So I'm gonna start off with a little bit of a heavier weight, and then I'll drop at one plate after I hit fatigue. So those rest days really do you good. I tell you what, I was like debating yesterday, should I work out today? Should I take it off? Because I was just kind of like, I could, but I really am not feeling the oomph. So, but I'm glad I took it off and rested, because today I feel freaking great. I got all carb back up and stuff. So I got some glycogen in the cells, and I feel like I got enough oomph to push it, you know, on a couple sets till failure today without overly taxing my system. So get those rest days in when you need them. Listen to that body. Okay, drop set for the middle deltoid right there, baby. Wow, slight bend in the elbows. Explosive on the way up. Little momentary split second squeeze at the top. Slow on the negative. Wow. So I'm getting about two or three reps in reserve here. Form's starting to sacrifice a little bit, so what I'm going to do now is just do a couple little partial reps. Not worry about getting all the way up, just getting a little bit of partial at that end range of motion, and then even that's getting hard. So now I'm going to do my drop. So full range of motion until you hit fatigue, then get a couple partials, and then a little drop set. And they're just, I can barely get it up now, so I'm gonna use a little body English here. Ooh, ah. Ah, shit, that's it, done, no mas. Good, give it a little squeeze, flex that shoulder, get that mind-muscle connection for a little resurrection. Wow. So there was a few advanced training methodologies kind of all thrown together there. So I went till pretty close to failure. Then I got a couple partials, drop set, even just to a handful more. So that really pretty much annihilated it right there. I got noodle arm now, definitely noodle arm. All right, let's hit the other side. Give a little minute for that one to recover, because that was a hard set. Like I said, on those harder sets, when you're pushing your central nervous system a little bit more, you hit that failure point and you do some advanced training methodologies, give yourself a couple minutes to relax and recover before you do the other side. Okay, giddy up. Partials. Ah. Ah. And drop set. Oosh. 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 Little body English. Bah. And flex. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Okay, time for some close grip pull downs. I'm gonna lean forward a little bit till I feel a really good stretch in the shoulder girdle. Drive the elbows down, chest up to the bar. Big squeeze at the bottom. Bar. Eesh. 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 Couple partials. Okay, second working set of the lat pull down right here, close grip. They don't have a machine here that actually like goes over the legs to like keep you down on this one, so I just sit on the floor, kind of brace my feet up against the machine. I don't use a crazy amount of weight anyways, so it's like my body weight keeps me down and I don't really need that pad anyways. So I'm just kind of making do with what we got here. And I'll probably do another pretty hard set on this one. I'm just gonna kind of listen to the body and you know, probably take this one till failure, maybe even do a little drop set here because I'm still feeling pretty strong. So get that good stretch at the top, really lean forward, open up those shoulders. Eesh. And dropping a couple plates here. Whoosh. Oh yeah. Okay, let's hit some upright rows, bros. So I'm about six sets deep into the workout. I did two working sets of one arm pull downs, two of the lateral raises, two of the close grip pull downs. I'll probably do another couple of the upright rows, and then I want to save just a little bit of steam in the tank to hit maybe just even a couple sets of some buys, maybe even a couple rear delts to finish it off. So that'll put me right around 10 to 12 total working sets for the whole workout, and I find that's pretty much about my max. Like if I start going past 12 total sets, like it's kind of diminishing returns at that point. Like the amount of oomph in the system has kind of been already expended on the previous sets. So for me, that's kind of like, I like to set my limit. 10 to 12, no mas, to be a boss. Here we go, a little upright row to blast out those shoulders, do a little maintenance work on the shoulders. Again, I'm just kind of like in somewhat of a maintenance on the growth side of things because I'm in a calorie deficit right now with the summer shred. So you don't want to try to put on a ton of mass really when you're in a deficit. Doesn't work so well. So I'm just kind of like doing what I call as a maintenance workout. For some people, this is training still pretty hard, but I've definitely taken it down a notch from, say, what I was doing when I was bulking, because you got that calorie surplus to really fuel your recovery better, right? Yeah, so make sure your calories on point with your target of your, whether it's a cut or a bulk. So I'm at about 20, let's see, where am I at now? I'm about 2,500 calories lately. I think I'm probably gonna just maybe inch them down ever so slightly because I've been kind of like stabilizing at that 203 point now for the last week or two. So, well, I feel good though because at first I started to cut a little too fast. I think I dropped my calories way too low because on my bulk, I was probably like, you know, 4,000 or something. And then I cut them way down a little too quickly. I should have known better, but I bonked a little bit. So then I said, screw that. And I brought them back up to more of a maintenance phase. That's kind of where I've been staying, where I've been at for the last couple weeks. Because I think I've been more in like a maintenance caloric intake. But now that I feel good, I got my energy back, I'm not all bonked out from being too low. Now, I'll just incrementally drop them ever so slightly. So I'm just cutting like a pound or two a week, and that's plenty. And like I said, if I don't cut any weight and I stay right where I'm at, but I still lose the body fat, like that's ideally what I'm after. I don't want the weight loss necessarily. I just want the fat loss. So if for some reason I'm one of those lucky individuals that can just stay around 200 and still drop the fat and just kind of recomp, still, you know, gaining a little bit of muscle as I lose the body fat, and that's the ideal world right there. Whoosh. Probably do a little drop set here because this will be the last set of shoulders for the day. A couple of partials. Done, son. Flex the shoulders. Wow. Squeeze those delts. Okay, I lied. I'm gonna do a couple more sets of shoulders. That was my last set of just the middle deltoid. I'm just gonna do a couple of the rear deltoid because you can't leave the rear delts hanging, right, bro? I mean, seriously. You wanna look like all imbalanced and awkward and shit? Skip your rear delts. Wow. Gonna do a little back and forth, left, right, and call it done for the delts. Ish. 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 Ah. Ah. Lights went dim on me again. Wah. Ish. Ish. Stretch. I'm just going to do a couple sets of some buys here. Little drop set. Start at the 45s, work our way down to the 40s, maybe even 35s. See how we're feeling. Just a little couple sets of some maintenance for the buys and call it good. Ugh. Shake it out, give it a good little 10 or 20 second recovery, and drop it down. All right, see you, brother.
Yeah.
Oh, hey. Oh, a couple more, about toes to toe. Oh, that's good. Oh, yeah. That's about it, dude. I got maybe uno mas for some preacher curls. Oh, blasted for sure. Okay, let's do a little physique check. Like I said, I'll put maybe like my before pictures up here on the screen somewhere too, so you can kind of see where I started at the beginning of the summer shred, and then kind of where I'm at right now. So, like I said, we're like 5 weeks in, and I still have a long ways to go. I started out with a pretty considerable amount of body fat, and I still have way more than I'd like, but it's starting to come together. You'll see when you see the before pictures versus now. So abs are starting to come back a little bit. Wow, ever so slowly. So I got the size maintained pretty good. Now it's just a matter of just stripping away some layers of body fat, and that's that. Oh, starting to get some obliques coming back in there a little bit. The main place that I seem to hold it is like right around the man boobs, right? A little man boob fat right in there, a little wiggle and jiggle. And then like the back love handles right in there where most of the guys have holding it, you know? Yeah, so that's that. Just keeping it real. Got a long ways to go, but I think another 8 weeks will put me right at that end of my summer shred, and I'll be just hitting my birthday, 52 years young, son, and hopefully looking good at the beach. Be able to take that shirt off at the beach and not feel like I'm the fat guy, you know what I mean? So, if you want to get buffed, if you want to get jacked without getting jacked up, you're over 40, you want to maintain your sporty, join us on the Ultimate Man Project and join us for our 12-week summer shred. Jump in for the win. I'll put a link in the description below. Just go to Get Coached. There's a little application there. Fill it out. Tell us what your goal is, whether it's like body recomposition, you know, whether you want to put on a little bit of size, drop some body fat. Whatever your goal is, let me know in the application, and then I'll hit you up, and we'll get you started, okay? Until next time, stay strong. Peace.